Ja, guten Abend. Und das Zustandekommen, ja, ist auch noch nicht so ganz klar, aber da kann ich den Peter fragen. Der kann natürlich sagen, wie das eigentlich kommt, dass wir heute Abend hier zusammensitzen und die drei Musiker auch zusammen auf der Bühne sind. Ja,
ja, also Jerry rief mich an vor ein paar Wochen, dass er mit Free Roll hier nach Deutschland kommt, weil die beiden kennen sich von Kindheitstagen aus, und zwar die waren mit ihren Familien, mit der Armee in Süddeutschland stationiert und waren zusammen in einer Schulklasse. Und
Do you have your first guitar on your own? No?
No, foolishly. I had Stratocasters, you know, and I would change one because the frets would start to buzz, so I'd take it into a shop, get another second-hand one in London, you know, I was in London by that time, and it just played a little bit better. I can't believe the gold mine I had slipping, you know, through my fingers and so on, yeah. But I've got a couple of, you know, old beauties, but I'll let a lot go, a lot of them go. And my original guitar was a classical Goyet, and that's long gone. That didn't even come to England with this, because I wanted to bring I had a jazz master first, and then I brought a spent all summer working to like get a precision bass, so I brought both of those with me over.
And what was the big influence to play guitar? Was it the brother or was it the gods? Because mostly in Europe, the boys learn guitar because they have more changes by gods.
Yeah. Yeah. To impress the girls. No, that wasn't my initial intention.
But it helps.
It helps, yeah.
It's the same in America.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah. Some things are the same in both countries. Well, all countries, probably. But no, it's just I heard an electric guitar once when I was growing up, and I just thought, whoa, that's such a fantastic sound, you know. And there was a tune called Woohoo by a band called the Rocketeens. Mm. If anyone's seen Kill Bill, there's a really bad bloody scene and all of that, and it's like going on. But that wasn't the version. The version I had sounded a lot cooler than that. It was a great, you know, had great guitar riff. You know, they were doing all that kind of stuff, and I thought, oh man, what a sound, you know. So I had to get a guitar. But my parents would only buy me a classical guitar to show, you know, you take lessons for a year, and if we think that you've developed sufficiently, shown enough improvement, I mean a lot of interest and improvement, then maybe we'll buy you your electric guitar at the end of the year. Well, practice all the time, you know, just never put the guitar down, so they had to cough up at the end of the year, you know.
And you remember the first piece they only got?
The first thing that I did, like?
No,
I was teaching myself some things before I started taking the lessons. I had a head start though, because my cousin in St. Louis, when I'd go and visit my dad, you know, my real dad was a band leader, and sometimes he'd play around the area and spend a week or something like that with his youngest sister's family. And so my uncle had a ukulele, and so I learned a lot of the chords on the ukulele before I got a guitar. And I was pleased when I got a guitar, you know, I had to teach myself from a book how to tune it. You know, I found that the bottom, you know, these three strings, you know, the only thing is different. It's just an octave higher, but otherwise, you know, you play the same four note chords. So all I had to do was teach myself, you know, the bottom two strings. So it was an enormous head start.
Freedom, you learn first bass?
No, it's interesting hearing Jerry say that. I learned ukulele first, the same color.
Wow.
I didn't know that until you said that. My father taught me a couple chords on the ukulele. Very hard to keep in tune.
Yes.
Yeah. You know, gut strings, and not very good instrument. Yeah. And and so, yeah, I learned the chords on ukulele, and then I went to a summer camp between junior and senior year of high school, and a counselor there was a folk singer from Philadelphia, and she played showed me how to play guitar, and it was the same thing. I could relate to the top four strings of the guitar as a ukulele, and I just put the bottom strings to it, which for me was easy because I think bottom up. That's the way I think bass. And so it's interesting you say that. Mm-hmm. And in fact, maybe I can share this with you. The first song that I learned. Where is my that very first song that I learned from this folk singer, Marilyn Schwartz, was an old folk song called Old Blue. Mm-hmm. I think Peter, Paul, and Mary did it. A bunch of people did it.
One of the first songs that he showed me back in, you know, when we were in college together.
Yeah.
Was Old Blue.
Old Blue,
yeah.
That's one of the first things we played together.
Yeah. Could I play it for you?
Yeah.
Should I plug it, or should you just want to do it acoustically?
Yeah, if you do it acoustically, yeah.
You can
play it. Still play.
Can you hear okay?
Yeah.
Was the link between Jerry and me, and that I would never have become a professional musician. That started me doing it. And when I went back to the States, I met some kids who were playing music, and they said, "We need a bass player." I said, "I can do that." and that became a well-known Philadelphia band. And I met a young Bonnie Raitt. And when the band broke up, she said, "Would you like to make a record with me?" In Minneapolis, 1971. And I said, "Sure." And we did some touring. And that lasted for more than 10 years. And I met a lot of people on the way. And I was on my way as a professional musician. So it never would have happened without Jerry. So to be here 50 years later and going back to that castle, back to the reunion, and playing music together, both having become professional musicians, two divergent paths, and meeting and still being friends and loving each other the way we do, is really, really a treat. It's a blessing, really. So
50 years after leaving the castle, you met again as a meeting at the
castle? We're doing these dates, you know, through Germany. We did some in Holland too.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to Berlin. We're doing a few over there, and then.
Oh, she playing at the embassy, at the U.S. embassy.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. In Berlin.
And then the ambassador's residence.
The ambassador's residence.
And then we have a day off, and then we drive down to
the
castle, the location. And there's a group of us. Only about a dozen of us can make it, but it'll be the same group, you know, people that we met back in 1964. So that's
jog our memory.
Yeah.
Memory.
Yeah.
We'll all come back.
That's going to be special. And we're doing a concert there too.
Oh.
All the locals, all the people from Kleinigusheim and neighboring villages and all that are invited.
Mm-hmm.
So that's why we're here.
So I'm going to do another one right away?
Right away.
Okay, this is one on my next album. I have recorded it. I haven't finished all the album though, but this is called First Encounter. Thank you.
nobody's like that. It just shows what's going on inside Jerry's head.
I still haven't figured it out.
No, nor have I. But it's okay. It's a good thing, Jerry. It's a good thing. We are all unique human beings.